Is this background cute? I can't tell. Well, we're gonna go with it. Welcome to my backyard. I am back home for a couple more days and then I head back to the city. So today I will be hauling kind of a vintage haul, thrift haul, etc. of different places around Massachusetts that I've hit. I highly recommend all of them. I vlogged at the places, but I think this format could be fun where I'm like sitting down and talking and then show you the video clips and things like that. Just want to try out a new format, so let's see how we like this. Yeah, I'm just feeling it. It's really nice outside. Birds are chirping. Wish I had some white wine in hand, but I don't. We don't have white wine here and I was too lazy to go get some. So anyways, was my phone here this whole time? That's so annoying. I'm so sorry that my phone was here. I'll put it on my lap. Before we get into the thrifted stuff, the vintage stuff, etc., I wanted to share some pieces that I got from Ana Luisa. And basically I remember seeing that they've done a couple collaborations with some YouTubers or influencers, etc., that I love, particularly being the collaboration with Lexi Lombard. So basically that is exactly what I got. So the first piece that I knew I wanted was Lexi's necklace, which is this absolutely stunning body. It's gold, it's delicate, it's dainty, it's the prettiest thing. It is such good quality. All of Ana Luisa's pieces are sustainable. They're ethically sourced or they're made from like recycled metals, etc. So it's really cool. I love supporting sustainable companies, etc. It's really good to find sustainable jewelers. Personally, I know of a lot of small businesses when it comes to like accessories and jewelry, but it's cool to see kind of like a bigger retailer stick to those sustainable roots and really value that. Just absolutely stunning, right? These birds are the squawking needs to stop, please. Anyways, this is so stunning. I can't wait to layer this. I can't wait to let her shine. It's a beautiful necklace that they came up with and I'm honored and happy to be able to wear it and embrace the divine feminine, if you will. Okay, my next piece, I'm so excited. I wish I was going to Greece so bad, like for many reasons, like who wouldn't wanna be there, but they just scream Santorini. Like, are you kidding? They're perfect. They're perfect. I love a little hoop moment. I think they're so cute. Perfect summer earring moment. I'm just excited to style them. And I also love how the metal on them is gold. I think the gold with the white and the blue looks so stunning. And then lastly, came in this kind of bigger pouch, are these gold hoops. I think they're honestly like the perfect size gold hoop. And again, quality of this jewelry is so good. The jewelry that I get is either like just really crappy jewelry, to be honest, and like cheap, or like again costume jewelry at like a thrift store, and you never know how worn that is or how nice that stuff is. So it's really nice to have like a good pair of earrings that I can trust. I also, my ears get really messed up from wearing cheap jewelry, especially when it's hot out and I'm sweating. It gets irritated. I often get like rashes on the back of my neck from like wearing cheap kind of like gold or silver jewelry. So I'm probably allergic to whatever metal that stuff is usually made out of. So I should look into that. That's a me thing. I think it's definitely important to check out brands that are a bit more upscale, better quality to invest in, because this kind of stuff like lasts you forever. And I feel like a good gold hoop in this size in particular is timeless. So I'm super happy about these and I can't wait to wear them. They go with my outfit right now. I'm going to put them on. Aren't they so cute? Like, they're just truly the perfect size hoop to me. And they're not, this is another amazing, beautiful aspect of these earrings, is they're not heavy at all. My big gold hoops that I wear all the time are so heavy. And I'd be like, I'm like just crazy talking all over the place, shifting my head, catching things on them. Like, it's just not a cute look. These are just way more of a better bet for me on all aspects of rashes, irritation, and weight on the lobes, if you feel me. And again, like, I got two earrings and a necklace, but they have rings, they have all of that. So do check them out. I'm linking their website below as well as their Instagram and stuff. But Ana Luisa, thank you so much for sending this stuff over. I absolutely love it and cannot wait to style it. And love, love, love that your company is sustainable and gorgeous and doing amazing things. Just love the pouches that everything comes in. Like, are you kidding? Like, these are just so cute, so easy to travel with. I love like a cute little thing, you know what I'm saying? So thank you again, Ana Luisa, for sending me those things. And I cannot wait to style them and wear them. And I'm gonna keep these in because they look super cute. Okay, let's get into Salvage Angel. I'll eat it. You guys, now I want this.
Stop.
It's only $25. Does Juanita, did I get it to add with my puppy paintings? Probably. Shout out Jessica. I don't really know a Jessica, but I would buy this for you if I did. Do you know Jessica?
Nope.
Shout out to all the Jessicas. $100, because look at how gorge with the tool. I want them, but I think they're too big. Shoe redemption. Loafers didn't fit, but these do. Warehouse of a bunch of different like consignment shops, thrift shops, shops that are more like curated, etc. Different like vendors and sellers, etc. But you would check out in like the one kind of register at the front. But it was a bunch of different people and businesses. I got a bunch of business cards. Again, it was just super cool to meet more people with small businesses and connect with them and see what they had and see what they're doing, because a lot of the stuff is like their ideas and things they make, etc. So that was super cool. The first thing I want to share is what I'm super excited about, and it is this 1998 church bells going off for Lady Di. Honestly, let's give her a moment. Rest in peace, Princess Diana. Are we done? Beautiful. Yeah. Okay, it had one more in it. Two more in it. I'm never filming outside ever again in the suburbs. Me pretending as if like this New York City is any better with background noise. Whatever. Basically, it's this 1998 calendar of Princess Diana. The pictures are just so gorgeous. And again, I mean, you guys know my obsession with Lady Diana, mine and Trisha's, and just the royal family in general. But Diana, like, she's the number one. We would die for her, etc. Like, she is the moment. Still to this very day, and I can't wait to frame this or do something with this. I'm very happy about this find. I believe it was $5. Going off of decor, I guess. I got this fabulous photograph that was framed of this beautiful car. Okay, this glare is not working for me. You guys know I bought those two dog frames in my last video in my birthday haul when I went to the Southampton like vintage market with my mom. And since then I've been trying to look out for more kind of like funky different frames, sizes, etc. Like paintings, pictures, whatever, just to make it super like cool eclectic look on a wall. And this was one of them. It's only $18 and I love it. And I like the wood frame. I think it's very 60s, 70s, and it'll be a cool contrast with like crazy gold frames that I have my dog paintings in. Okay, because they're on the floor right by me, and because I'm super excited about them. Basically, as you saw in the vlog clips, I loved these loafers, and I really wanted them. I thought they were super cool. Yeah, they were way too big. Like, I was like, oh, I could wear a fuzzy sock with them. Not like it was really bad. It looked like I was wearing like my dad's oversized shoes, and I was like a little girl like walking around her living room. Yeah, I just couldn't swing it. So I was like kind of bumming. Kieran and I are about to check out, and we had looked at the cowboy boots at the front, right? Hadn't seen these were on the floor. I am obsessed with these. From the shape to the color brown, there are kids screaming if you guys can hear that. I live near a lot of families, so I promise you nobody's getting murdered. It's a little kid screaming, playing tag probably. Don't be alarmed. But yeah, what I was saying, from the shape of the boot to the toe kind of peeking up to the wedged heel to the, like, these are beautiful. And like, they're Stenson, handmade in Mexico. Like, it makes sense why they're this beautiful, but also kind of pricey. I mean, they were $95. It's not too bad, but they were size 8. They fit me. So maybe I think either these run big, my feet shrunk, or I didn't give a fuck in that moment. I was like, no, they fit. And I was playing dumb just because I love them. Yo, what the fuck? I can't. These birds are fucking going crazy. Hey, last time I filmed outside here. Sorry, everybody. back to the boots. The crosses. Are you kidding me with the studs? These are just so bad ass. And like I said in the video, kind of Chrome Hearts vibes, but even better. Like, I just can't deal. I love how the crosses come onto the foot of the boot. Like, are you kidding? Yeah, so I'm just super excited about these. They are gonna look so cute with anything and everything. And okay, kids, let's pipe down. I know we're having fun, but I'm trying to film a YouTube video. Thanks so much. 80s prom dress realness. Yeah, I'm obviously doing a try on with the clothing items that I got, but this was hard to zip. It was like definitely a 2 to 3 person job. If I can't get the zipped, I'll just hold it in the back because it's tight for sure. Love the bow, love the rhinestone detail. I think this with orange tights and like a fun, wish I had a YSL heel, I don't, a fun kitten heel, a chunky heel, something with like a cross lace up moment, fun glasses, groovy hair, like something really, like just like a moment, crazy vibes. I don't know, I think it could be super fun. I love it. So next is this fabulous, amazing turquoise and blue trench coat, which I think would look so good. I have this outfit in my brain with these tights, leggings, whatever you want to call them. These, love, love, would die for these. This vibe is so, like, I need to get in there. I need to start doing this. I think a pair of those leggings underneath this with either like a tank top or a fun graphic tee or like a bra or something with like a kitten heel or a cowboy boot, fun glasses, slick back bun. She's just your classic trench shape, but in what looks like a snowsuit / sleeping bag. Color, aesthetic, fabric, all of the above, and I had to get it. Then what I got are these pants that basically, I have these pants from the brand Wilson that kind of got fucked up in the wash when my washing machine was losing it and my clothes were locked. Flashback to the last video.
Literally, fuck you, girly pop.
The color, something happened and they dyed those pants and now they look super kind of gross and musty because they have like this gray tint to them. I'm still gonna wear them, all of that, but I really wanted another pair with a brighter color palette, so found these and they're perfect. Adidas swooshy pants, white, green, and royal blue, and I think they're so cute. Happy about this find for sure. Woo. Why are birds like tweaking me out right now? Sorry. I'm super excited about these because jean shorts don't usually like fit me too great, or they're just like always kind of tight. They fit super great. They're kind of like a denim booty short. That's how I would describe them. I think they're super cute. I love the back. I love this no excuses little tag here. I just think they're so cute. These were from Bitchy Vintage, bitchy.vintage on Instagram. They're so cute and these were like 20 bucks, so not terrible. Then I got this tie. This was from Secret Sun Vintage. The other pieces that I've hauled didn't have tags on them, and I didn't really know which shop that they were from, so that's why I didn't share them because I'm unsure, but obviously I'm going to share which shops the ones with tags are from. It's a 1996 Bud Light tie and it says I love you man on it with Bud Light. I think it's hilarious. Then last thing, I think it gave me like Dua Lipa vibes, and plus this picture of Bella Hadid specifically before the Jacquemus show. I really like the bow detail and the diamonds. Like, I just think this is gonna be super fun to wear with nothing under it. Low waist pants, cardigans and like sweaters are really hard for me to find ones that like I love, and that one's really cute, so I'm excited to style that and play around with that. I love the bow. I think it's so unique. That's everything I got from Salvage Angel. If you want to ever check it out, if you're ever in the area, it was awesome. I highly, highly recommend it, and it seems like a great place for moms, like a fabulous place to take your mom. Like, if you and your mom are ever in Massachusetts, head there. Then we went to Vivant Vintage. It's one of my faves. Hi, everybody. We're going to Vivant Vintage now. I am completely and utterly speechless. These are an extra small. I don't think they'll fit.
Like layer necklaces and a slip underneath.
I don't know, I'm loving open knit vibe. I try on these
silky little shorts.
Saying my goodbyes. So basically tried on a bunch of things, fell in love with these hot pants, these booty shorts from the 60s, 70s, vintage, so cool, one of a kind, haven't seen any of them. Ugh, just really did not fit. Like there was just no way I was making that work. Like I know my thighs, and when I saw those, I was like, it's not looking good for you guys. And then also this dress that I loved also didn't fit. And then everything else was either really cute, but too much money for it to be cute. Like I tried on this like kind of jersey shirt that was purple and yellow. Love the color combo. It's like $56 and I was like for like a jersey long sleeve t-shirt, I don't want to spend that. So but Vivant Vintage has a really good lingerie section. It's tiny but mighty, I promise you. And as you guys know, they have my lampshade pantaloons, or whatever you want to call them, bloomers, etc. I busted mine open, as you can see here.
So cute, you know. And then for the pop of red, I added,
yeah, rip. I was so sad. So I bought two more pairs as backup because I am in love with them. So two new pairs. I talked to the girl that was working there. She said she has these, she dyed them black, and of course I'm going to do that, or dye them a fun color. And they're my favorites, and they save me when things are too short, when things are sheer, whatever. They save my life and add such a cool look to an outfit and added detail, and I'm obsessed with them. The two other pieces I got at Vivant, I'm obsessed. Okay, this picture, right? Got it in your brain? Found it in a belt buckle. What the fuck? How cool is this? So cool. 1978, baby. I don't know if you can read that, but it's from 1978. Yes, I paid $24 for this. Like, this is worth my money. This is everything to me. Bolo freaking tie. So excited about it. Cannot wait to layer things with this. Okay, sorry, my camera stopped filming, so I'm back. First off, I love the people dancing on it. I hope that focuses, or you can even see that. So cute, first of all. Then I also love like the string, the leather string that it's on. So cool. I don't know, another accessory that I don't want to sleep on anymore. You know what I'm saying? So my obsession with ties does not end with a classic formal tie. It also includes bolo ties. Thank you very much. Let's end it. End it strong with savers.
We picked up Wayne Van McQueen.
Hi. It's literally so dark. There you are. So cute. We are going to savers now instead of high energy vintage because time, yeah, we're kind of hitting rush hour at this point, and it's not the smartest use of our time right now, so we're gonna go to Savers. See you there.
I thought we had a blue.
Slide.
We have a
navy. I like
this
a lot.
You cannot, you know, black.
Really? No, thank you. No, thank you.
Oh, this thing also has that weird stuff.
That's okay.
No.
Found these two vases.
Whoa. Whoa.
No idea where I'm putting them. But I love them. Didn't find a bunch of stuff at all. We were kind of like beat from the day. We were going to go to High Energy, which you guys know is one of my favorite thrift shops. Went to Savers instead. Got a couple things. So, got this tank top in the pajama section. It just seemed really cozy to me. It's the brand Lazy Zone. It says, I don't do mornings, which I do mornings actually. I actually do mornings, but no, I am quite a morning person, but still. Isn't that so cute? He's so cute. And I love the colors. I love the pink with the purple piping. It's a long tank top, but could crop it. Might not want to though. Just seems like the coziest little PJ top. So I'm excited about that. I also think like with low waist jeans and like a hat could be just a cute running errands top, whatever. So thought that was cute. Got it. Love it. Last two pieces. I was speechless at this. I didn't get the same energy from Phoebe and Kieran, but I feel like these vases would be sold for so much money on like a reselling Instagram something. Maybe not, maybe not. But particularly this one, because there's that lamp that people are obsessed with that's literally this kind of like glass work. Do y'all know what I'm talking about? It's pink and it's beautiful and it has kind of like a spiral detail. There you go, you can see it better this way. Yeah, there it is. She's so cute. Love her. Had to get her a bestie. Love this. They're both so large. You guys know I love a spiral, and this is all spirals all over it. Each of these were under $5. And I love the blue. I think the blue and the pink, they're quite heavy. I think they're super cute together. I don't know what I'm gonna do with them yet. I don't know where I'm gonna put them in my apartment, to be honest, right now. They might stay in my room at home until I move into, you know, my next place. And I start from scratch when it comes to decor and all that jazz. But I love the two of these guys. I couldn't pass them up. That was it for all the things that I thrifted and bought today and collected throughout my hunt today. I'm super happy with everything. I'm super excited to style it all. Oh, actually, I did want to share one more thing that I got today. My sister gave them to me for my birthday, and I've been wanting these for an actual year or two maybe. And they became so popular that Phoebe like could not buy them in my size, couldn't find them in the color that I wanted. But I was like, you know what, I don't care what color, I think they're super fun, any color, whatever. Yeah, babes, I'm talking platform Crocs. You guys already know I wanted these. I feel like I've mentioned that before. She got me a bag of like random gibbets that I've put on, but I definitely want to get like more gibbets that are like a bit of me, you know what I'm saying? But I have Harry Potter, SpongeBob, Batman, a pirate, and a My Little Pony on this one. Definitely vibes, you know what I'm saying? But it's not like screaming Chloe, you know? And I also want like funny gibbets. I am keeping Batman for sure though, because my brother and I grew up playing Batman and Robin. Guess which one I was? Robin, obvi. And then this one I have, who do I have on here? Another SpongeBob, a paw print, which I thought would be cute because that's my tattoo, even though my tattoo is a bear claw. Whatever, paw print, bear claw, let it ride. And then Phoebe bought me basically the pack. She was like, you needed this Leo gibbet. And I was like, of course. So my Leo one, put a little dino on it. Tractor, love it. Eyeball, love it. Good vibes, random, colorful. Just love the weird, wonky look of the Croc. And they're so comfortable, you guys. And again, you guys have known I've had my cheetah print Crocs for a while now. And I love them, I wear them all the time. You can obviously, you know, I have them in sport mode right now, but you can flip them up, keep them slip-on vibes. You guys know the energy, you guys know Crocs. I'm not pretending as if this is your first rodeo with Crocs. I'm saying if you're not into the revisiting of the Crocage, I'm encouraging you take a second look. Okay, everybody, that is it. I feel like I've been chatting your ear off. So yeah, that's wraps for me. Stuff. Somebody's calling me. It's Linda. Do you want to say hi to my video?
Yeah.
You actually want to see this vase? I feel like you're gonna love. Doesn't it look just like the was it a vase? Yeah, that. Okay, wait, hold that right there. I need to show my video. Okay, you guys, it's this lamp that I was talking about. Thank you, Linda, for the feature.
Yes.
Yes.
Perfect.
Anyways, fun, right? That was sweet. Thank you so much for watching this video. I appreciate your support and your watching and all your comments and video suggestions and all of that. As always, keep letting me know what you guys want to see. I'm always interested and, you know, always need the occasional help trying to plan a video every week. Stay fabulous, stay beautiful, have a fabulous rest of your day, night, evening, whatever it may be. And I will see you in my next video. I love you guys. Bye-bye.